Hey, welcome back to How to Be Less
Derp
in the great fun free-to-play game called
Planetside 2.
In the last episode, we discussed how you can find yourself on the map with a single keystroke and how to move the camera inside the cockpit of an ESF. Check the description of the video for a link to the Be Less Derp playlist in case you missed any due to having fun harassing Radar X on the forums. I don't blame you. The combat medic has finally finished medical school and is now ready to play with some additional toys and buffs. The ability slot can now be retrofitted to carry a shield regeneration tool that can repair shields continuously in a 7-foot area. Hit the F key to pull it out of your doctor's bag and deploy it with the left mouse button. You can gain heal XP by repairing shields in this way, which is also pretty useful for recently rezzed characters. Please note that even though this grants a new tool to the class, due to overwhelming costs of medical school, they could not place it in the utility slot, where it would be far more useful. This means you can no longer heal in an AoE around you and cannot heal yourself outside of the shields either. Be sure to equip medical or restoration kits, or at least bring along healing grenades. Speaking of healing grenades, they now heal just as fast as restoration kits and cover a whopping 10 meters! So throw on your grenade bandolier and go crazy! Medics can now enjoy new faction-specific assault rifles like the Atros, Terminus, or Torque 9, and can now stop being jealous of heavies and engineers by equipping the very same battle rifle those classes have access to. But wait, there's more! Now you can equip the adrenaline pump that both light assault and infiltrators use to run a little faster to that big old pile of bodies rotting in the corner. Triage, that passive healing ability to friendlies in the same vehicle as you, has now been buffed to affect friendlies on the outside of the vehicle up to 5 meters as well while you are inside shooting at the enemy. It's too bad triage wasn't made into a deployable for the utility slot as requested over a year ago on this channel, but you never know. Maybe SOE will still grant us our wish down the line. Pretty please? Oh please? We'll gladly give up our C4 for that, we promise. Finally, after months of requests, you can check out the Nanite Systems Baron Shotgun, which you can equip on every class except Infiltrator and Max, and on every faction in the game. It fires like a standard semi-auto shotgun, but reloads like a pump action, so make sure you're safe before hitting the R key. You know what this MMO really needs? Loot! Yes, a loot system has been added to Planetside 2. The implant system has been integrated but completely redesigned from Planetside 1. Here's a really simple explanation for all you old grannies out there worrying about additional confusion on the battlefield. As you earn XP, you will also get implants as drops automatically on your character. You can equip them in the loadout screen like any of your other equipment, giving you various perks during gameplay like health regen between fights, seeing enemy health, getting a rangefinder added to your reticle, having the ability to fall farther before taking damage, and so on. More implants will come in the future from Nanite Ned himself. Implants can also be turned off, similar to camo and vehicle chassis, by just clicking on the same one again. Implants also need energy and eat a set amount of energy when they are equipped. Once you're out of energy, you lose the enhancement from the implant, but the implants are permanently yours until you decide to throw them in the nanocycler. When you get implants you aren't interested in or extras you do not need, hit escape and go to the nanocycler tab. Hit the help button at the top of the screen for a detailed explanation of how to use this new tool to make your Araxian life easier. To put it in a nutshell, in order to destroy implants to create additional energy, click on any tier 2 or higher implant and a tier 1 implant to create a charger. Put any 3 tier 1 implants in to create another random tier 1 implant. Put 5 tier 1 implants in to create a random tier 2 implant. Remember, implants are permanent unless you choose to destroy them here, so be careful as you work your way up to having all the tier 3 implants at your disposal. It's really just that simple. To speed up the process, you can also spend cert points or station cash to buy implants and energy chargers, plus you can automatically get an implant immediately upon the implementation of the new system. Hey, just calm down. I know that the cert tab is missing, but you can actually get access to the certs in the classes menu, and if you're looking for the leadership cert tree, open up the social tab to unlock leadership chat in order to annoy the guys who actually aren't derp. Oh, and hey, stop blowing up your flash, soldier. Nanite Ned and his goons have made it more difficult to flip and spin out in them, so you can save your mechanized resources for that lovely lightning that is now available at every vehicle terminal. Yay!
Thanks for watching our video and subscribe to Energy One. Learn how to be less derp with Channel Energy One.
Generator, stay. Hang on, boys.